Hey, YouTubers, and welcome back to another episode of NBA 2K15 My GM with the Oklahoma City Thunder franchise. This is episode 3 here on ESGN.net, and we are getting ready for our second game of the season. As you see there, we won that first game against Portland 83-79. A bit of a nail biter towards the end, but hopefully that won't be the case here as we get ready to play against the LA Clippers here. CP3 and Blake Griffin and crew will be our opponents in this game. As you see, we are ranked third in the power rankings there, but we're currently tied in first place right now with the Nuggets, both winning a game here early on in the season. So we'll get ready for game two here. Now we're ranked 90 overall, and of course the Clippers are 94 here. So it's going to be a good back and forth game here, and I'm sure you guys are going to enjoy this. So as always, you guys will see the game in full entirety, and we'll actually have show you guys a treat here. We'll show you guys the pregame show with Shaq here in just a bit. But there you see the starting lineups there for both squads, and we'll see what the point of emphasis there will be. Of course, we will have to defend the paint there against Blake Griffin. Of course, then we have to worry about also the perimeter shooting there from CP3, of course, with his his good way of moving the ball around with a lot of assists and stuff. So he's going to move that ball around enough to really get us going here. So we'll have to see if we can stop him here. But right now, enjoy the pregame show and also the game here coming up here on MyGM OKC Thunder franchise. See you guys after the game.
And brought to you by Sprite. It's the 2K pregame show.
Man, I've been waiting for this for so long. It's the start of another NBA regular season. Along with Shaquille O'Neal, I'm Ernie Johnson. And it's happening out at Staples Center, where the Los Angeles Clippers will be going up against the Oklahoma City Thunder. And for Oklahoma City, they got their season rolling with a nice win in their first game. Now we'll find out if they can build on it and open with back-to-back victories. Let's talk about Blake Griffin, Shaq. He's improved his shot, correct? I mean, has he shown steady improvement in your book?
Yes, Ernie, that's because hours before the game, he's on the court working on this shot. He smoothed out that hitch a little bit. And Ernie, when he's hitting that shot from the outside, he is unguardable.
With the game about ready to tip off, we check in with Kevin Harlan.
And now, introducing your Los Angeles Clippers. At the small forward position, 6'7", number 22, Matt Barnes. Matt Barnes, 6'5", from Michigan, number 11, Jamal.
Should be a terrific battle.
Well, if this is a matchup that feels familiar, it's because it is. Just last season, they were knocked out of the conference semis by this club.
So here's Oklahoma City's starting group. Ran outside at the three with Ibaka playing the power forward. And Anthony Morrow out there with Russell Westbrook. And it's Perkins in at the five, roaming the paint.
And they get on the board first,
looking to set the tone early.
If you just look at the numbers, you are not seeing the real impact of Kendrick Perkins. I mean, he is just this mountain at the rim as a protector of the paint. And it really makes it hard for opponents to get easy shots because of his presence.
He can fly, can he? He'll make you forget he's a point guard sometimes.
Yeah, when he does decide to attack the basket, Kevin, he can do it with the best of them.
And this is the time to attack with these two teams locked in such a close game.
So it's the Clippers now, following the score by Oklahoma City. Just five to shoot. Plus, here's Paul. Russell Westbrook with the rebound. Los Angeles on D. Four-point game. Dishes to Durant. Let's go. And it's off the back rim. No good. You know, Steve, with Perkins, the defense at the rim might be the best thing he brings to the table. He is a solid defensive player for sure all around, but his ability to make life miserable on inside shots is special.
Well, I think he's one of the elite low post defenders in the league. You know, when he has to go against the big scorers down on the block, whether it's Tim Duncan or Hibbert, he does as good a job as anybody because of his strength and his intelligence, just understanding what he's facing night in and night out.
Here's Crawford, the Thunder making the shot, and the basket good. Westbrook with it. He had 13 points in the win against the Trailblazers in Portland.
And he was so good defensively, anticipating every pass. I mean, he had a ton of steals in that game.
Now here's Durant. Oklahoma City moving it around. Six on the shot clock. Here's Ibaka. Second shot opportunity. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Nice work to get inside and draw the foul.
Yeah, it's obvious. The defense not going to allow many easy layups. They're going to make you earn it from the line.
Oklahoma City shooting their first shots of the night from the charity stripe. He misses the free throw. And the second free throw, good.
The Thunder were the second best road team in the NBA last year. Normally, a jump shooting team might have trouble on the road, but they are just that good.
Outside Westbrook. Outside Durant. Here's Morrow. The basket good off the assist from Durant. Morrow's got his first basket of the night. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for the Thunder.
Boy, their frenetic defense has really been impressive, putting a lot of pressure on ball handlers and turning them over.
They've gotten their fair share of points off turnovers so far tonight, too.
When you can shoot like this Thunder team can, you can play outdoors, Steve, and still find a way to win it.
Yeah, I mean, playing on the road or on the moon, it wouldn't faze them regardless. Their 25 road wins is a testament to just how unflappable this club is.
Now here's Barnes, following the shot by Kevin Durant. It's Crawford with the drive, and count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
Beautiful cut to the hoop. He's getting anything he wants here already.
Well, Jamal Crawford has proven that no matter what role he plays, just call him buckets. He can flat out put the ball in the basket. You got to give him a lot of credit, though. He does change his game quite a bit depending on if he's coming off the bench or starting. I think that speaks to his IQ.
Now here's Durant. He had a 36-point outing in the last game against Portland.
And he gave him great effort defensively as well, including a couple of blocked shots.
Here's Ibaka. The shot misses. So Los Angeles will take it the other way.
And as you said with Jamal, a lot of players can't really make that change between being a starter or a sub. But he does it so smoothly in such short time, it really adds. adds a lot of utility to this team.
Maybe they're still working out the Kings defensively because that was a blatant mistake.
Got a piece of it, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Thunder will retain possession. Here's the 2K leaderboard with last season's best free throw shooting teams. Second, the Thunder.
You know, it's interesting when you look at this team, Kevin. I mean, they found a way to get their whole team to knock down free throws at a consistent level. I mean, a team that can't make free throws, that's a huge liability and one you don't want to deal with. They'd like to repeat their success at the line this year.
Here's Morrow. 8 points his last outing. Offensive rebound. Perkins with the bucket. Perkins got 5 points so far.
Did you see the defense get caught standing around that time, giving up an easy second chance bucket?
Simply need more of an effort on the boards there, Steve.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here. Well, Crawford described it perfectly, Clark, when he said as a sixth man, you have to come in and force yourself into the game. At the start of the pressure isn't there as much as you can go with the flow.
Yeah, players like him can often do one or the other. Come in firing off the bench or let the game come to you. But rarely can they assess what the team needs like Crawford does and adjust on the fly so smoothly.
Evan, well, look here at last year in the NBA where the Clippers ranked. Tops in scoring, third in assist, and they were ranked third in team field goal percentage. This is a team that shared the ball and got quality shots on a regular basis.
But when you get down to it, I mean, the identity of this club is that they score the ball. Number one in the league, they have so many ways to hurt you, and that seems to inspire them with confidence every single game.
Clippers trail by four. Now we'll go to Doris Burke, who had a chance to talk with head coach Doc Rivers.
He knows one of the hardest parts on scoring against this defense has to do with their prolific shot blocker, Serge Ibaka. He told me he's one of those guys who can get in your head a little bit because he's so mobile. You often don't see him coming. And Kevin, you add in his great rebounding and ability to hit from mid-range, and he's always an X factor for them. Back to you.
Thanks again, Doris. Oklahoma City comes into this one after the win against the Trailblazers in Portland.
You know, their percentage from long range in that game was off the charts. It seemed like every time the home crowd got going, they just took the wind out of their sails with another three-point barrage.
Yeah, those bombs were really falling.
Here's Morrow. Back to Westbrook. Five on the clock. Front pass the arc. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. Jordan's got three rebounds so far in the game. He lobs up the alley-oop pass, and Griffin slams it in.
What a beautiful pass to set that one up.
The pass might have been pretty, but the finish, I thought, Clark, angry.
That's a heck of a combination. Pretty pass and an angry punch.
You call it an irate finish.
Boy, they're really doing good work in the paint.
And working the paint has helped to build this early lead.
And Kevin, you know, that's one of the easiest ways, or one of the best ways to build the lead is by getting high percentage shots, by taking that ball inside and then controlling the paint area. It puts a lot of pressure on the defense.
And it builds confidence, too.
Exactly. Yeah. Well said.
Catching up on the changes for the Clippers. Spencer Hawes is checked in for Jordan. Davis comes in for Blake Griffin. J.J. Redick's checked in for Jamal Crawford. And it's Farmall in for Chris Paul.
Well, this last season was the Clippers' 30th in Los Angeles. And for a team that's long played in the Lakers' shadow, for the second season in a row, the Clippers were the best team in L.A.
Nick Collison's checked in for Berkowitz. So it's the Clippers now. They trail by six. Here's Davis from down in the low post. It goes.
And for the Clippers, in their 30 years in L.A., folks, only six times have they finished the regular season with a better winning percentage than the Lakers. Man, it's been domination by the Lakers out there in L.A. land. So Clipper fans are hoping that this is a sign of things to come going forward for their team, the Clippers.
Down to five on the shot clock. Durant attacking. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
Well, those chances are almost always 2 points for him. I guess the defense did what it had to do to bother him.
Farmar passes to Redick. Pause up top. It's stolen by Lamb. Adams outside. Durant for three. And Adams gets to Lamb. For three, Durant. Durant with another miss.
His touch has disappeared on him this quarter. He just hasn't been able to get it going.
And guys, for the Clippers, acquiring coach Doc Rivers from the Celtics in exchange for a draft pick. In Boston, he'd been the second longest tenured coach in the league after Greg Popovich.
Yeah, but rather than rebuild, I think he wanted to go for another ring in L.A. He's got a lot of authority, final say on personnel decisions. So Doc has really put his stamp on this team.
You know, he's not somebody they lean on for points, but when he does score, that's a bonus.
51 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Fires top of the key. Good as the jump shot falls. Durant's got six.
You know, that's one way he can finish, but not the only way. He's got a lot of tricks up his sleeve.
And that's a foul. It's called on Reggie Jackson. That's his first foul.
That's his first personal foul. Second team foul.
And here are the Clippers now. Four-point game. Farmar dishes to Redick. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
Their low post defense has to show some improvement, guys.
Yeah, of the last 10 points, Steve, eight have come from in tight.
The Clippers have shot just one free throw early, one for one in the game.
And not a very strong free throw shooting team in general. Guys, they shot 73% as a team a year ago.
And, you know, there was plenty of blame to go around for that. I mean, it wasn't just one or two guys. I mean, for the most part, the entire team struggled.
Now here's Jackson. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. There's a four-second difference from the shot clock to the game clock. Oklahoma City moving the ball around. And he's good on the three ball. And the Thunder lead by four. 12 seconds left here in the first quarter. Here's Redick, and he gets it to go. Redick's got his first bucket of the night.
Beautiful job angling his body, shielding the big man from the ball on his way to the basket.
That's really the only way to do it if you're going to take it down there amongst the tall trees.
And so the first quarter wraps up without too much action on the scoreboard. Oklahoma City out in front. They lead by two. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break.
It's a Halloween broadcast of the NBA. LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers take on Derrick Rose and the Chicago Bulls this Friday, 7 p.m. Central. Don't miss it.
And off we go. A close game now starting the second quarter. What do you guys think about the Thunder here in this one?
And the key is you look at the steal totals for this team. They have really put good pressure on the offense.
Well, you know what? Pressure can lead to pilfers, and pilfers can lead to points. So we've got the three P's: pressure, pilfers, points. Get it done.
The Clippers trail. Blake Griffin down low and DeAndre Jordan. CP3 at point with Redick there at the back. And it's Crawford at the small forward position. They're the group out there for the Clippers starting the second quarter. To the wing right side. Six to shoot. Here's Redick. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
J.J. Redick, acquired by the Clippers going into last season. A great fit, but injuries really held him back. First surgery to repair ligaments in his wrist, then a bulged disc in his lower back. Ended up playing just 35 games in the regular season.
And Redick, were it not for the injuries, was on pace, Clark, for the best season of his eight-year NBA career.
Kevin would have been a career high in points per game. Great efficiency for Redick as well. He flourished playing alongside former ACC rival CP3, Chris Paul.
Thank you. and it's tied up with that one.
Well, you know, every time these two teams face off, it is Battle Los Angeles. For so long, the Lakers have really owned the city. But the Clippers looking to make up for lost time right now.
That is good. And the Thunder lead by two. The Clippers shooting impressively throughout at 62%. Oh, and there's the alley-oop. Oh, a nice defensive play to disrupt the alley-oop. Outside Westbrook. Morrill kicks to Collison. And that one's good. And now a four-point Thunder lead. And a bit of controversy, guys. Last season, Doc Rivers had the Lakers championship banners covered up for Clipper home games.
I thought it was a smart decision, Kevin. I mean, you got to make it your home gym. And all they did was hang up banners of their own players. A smart move by Doc. And, you know, the Clippers will forever be in the Lakers' shadow in L.A., regardless of the results of the games.
And let's now go to the sideline. We'll catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, Kevin, there is no question that Chris Paul has been the leader wherever he's gone. He demands a lot from his teammates, but they respect his passion. Paul has no time for anyone who feels they don't need to work. He doesn't like guys who take things for granted. Certainly not someone to rest on his laurels, gentlemen.
Holding everyone accountable, Doris, thanks. The Thunder shooting their fourth and fifth shots at the foul line in the game. And he knocks down the first one.
Russell Westbrook, one of the best success stories when it comes to converting a scoring guard to playing the point. But it's his overall talent that's made him successful. His will, his competitiveness, and his incredible athleticism.
Kendrick Perkins, he's checked in for Nick Collison. That one misses, so he goes one for two.
And Westbrook is a phenomenal rebounder and scorer at the point guard position. He gets steals. He really is one of the stat sheet stuffer supreme guys in the league.
Jackson passes to Morrow. The three. That's good. Morrow's got five.
D there, guys, was pretty much non-existent. I mean, you can't leave a good shooter like that open.
And Westbrook, every season among the league leaders, Steve, in assists, but also, unfortunately, in turnovers.
Well, with his scoring burden, you know, that's to be expected. But it's definitely an area he can continue to improve.
And so it's Oklahoma City with it. They'll host the Denver Nuggets after this one. That game is the first and last of their homestand. Jackson. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Now here's Redick, the fast break opportunity.
Man, that's too bad. Easy shot there, and you got to knock that one down.
Well, that's a concentration cramp right there. I mean, just lost focus.
Stolen by Jackson. Outside Westbrook. The feed now to Ibaka. And he uses the glass on the layup. And the Thunder lead by 10.
He got a little room at the rim and laid it in. Great play.
Clippers have gone 0-3 and are still looking for that first bucket here in the second quarter.
Reggie Jackson is really strong and athletic. Excellent driver and finisher.
College, but it seems, Steve, he's still adjusting to the NBA three-point range.
Well, last year he shot about three of them per game, Kevin. Made a little more than a third of his attempts, so he needs to shoot a better percentage from the corners in particular. But, you know, as a ball handler, he's a good setup man, good assist man.
With this pause in the action, let's show you the teams that have scored the most points in the league last season. The Clippers, number one. Fifth on the list, the Thunder.
Yeah, you love when you get these two teams together. Just an absolute shootout because they put up a ton of points last year.
quarter number two, around 3 minutes gone by. The dish to Jordan. Paul kicks to Griffin. Back to Paul. Four on the clock. The Clippers need to get off a shot. That one goes. Count.
Now he's one of the best in the league when it comes to executing that lead pass.
On offense, here are the Thunder. They're on a 10-2 run here. Westbrook kicks to Morrow. Back to Westbrook. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. Russell Westbrook, maybe the most athletic and explosive point guard ever to play in the NBA. As some people would say, what about you?
Well, you know, it's hard to say ever, but Russell Westbrook clearly plays with the kind of ferocity that I've not seen at the point guard position. The only guy that comes to mind is probably Derrick Rose prior to his injury. I think Westbrook's aggression, powering through contact, probably gives him the edge. I mean, he plays almost angry.
A lot of torque.
A lot of torque. I mean, it's something to behold. I've not quite seen a guy at the point guard spot bring that kind of athleticism and speed and tenacity to the position.
Well, I like how you mentioned Rose, because I would agree, and that's a great, great way to kind of figure out where he is when Rose is healthy.
Yeah, exactly.
The pre-injured Rose was...
He was right in that same category.
You got it. And there's the pass to Perkins. Shoots. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. Perkins got nine.
Now they've settled into a pretty nice groove here offensively in the second quarter.
Yeah, I like the way they picked up the pace shooting the ball. I mean, the field goal percentage upwards of 50% now.
Redick dishes to Paul. Lock at six. Stolen by Westbrook. Here we go with Morrow running it up the court. It's good, the assist this time from Jackson. And now an 11-point Thunder lead.
You know, regardless of who starts the break, it seems like he's usually the one to finish it.
And that's because of how well he attacks the rim on the dead run.
The drive by Paul. Feeds it to Crawford. And it takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. He has seven.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Boy, the ball movement's been fantastic here the last few possessions.
Oklahoma City moving it around. Back to Westbrook. Pass to Morrow. Down low. It's tipped. And it's out of bounds to the Thunder as Oklahoma City retains possession.
Super defensive play. I mean, if that pass gets through, it's probably 2 points.
And he knew that. He knew if it gets through, it's a score. So that's why he sold out for it and got a hand on it.
Here's what the Clippers are going with right now. Spencer Hawes is checked in for Jordan. Davis comes in for Blake Griffin. Barnes is checked in for J.J. Redick. And it's Farmall in for Paul. Durant just inside the line. And Davis pulls it down.
That's not a sight you see very often. I mean, he has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when he's open.
Okay, well, let's check in with Doris Burke reporting from our sideline in this game. Doris, take it away.
Hey, Kevin. Well, Coach Doc Rivers certainly hasn't minced words since joining the Clippers. He's held each player accountable and defined roles. He told DeAndre Jordan he wouldn't run any plays for him, that he just wanted him to focus on defense. Jordan said, Doc knows how to reach people. There are egos on every team, and he knows how to control all of that. It's honesty. Refreshing, gentlemen.
Champion with the Celtics. He's one of the best coaches in the league. Thanks, Doris. Durant against Crawford. And Durant gets it to go. Durant's got 8 points.
You know, everybody knows that the Thunder are a good offensive team, but the reason why is they have such balance offense. let's take a look at how Oklahoma City ranked in the league last year. Second in blocks, second in free throw percentage, and they were ranked third in opponent field goal percentage. This team really gets after it defensively. They made a commitment to that end of the floor.
And I think the thing that jumps out at me is the blocks per game. It just shows how well coached they were defensively. Great rotations, they closed out, and they forced their opponents into tough situations at the hoop. That's how they were able to block so many shots.
And Hawes kicks to Crawford. To the middle. That's it, and the Oklahoma City leaders get down now to just 11 on the bucket from Hawes. Oklahoma City's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. It's Durant on the wing. There's 1:26 left in the first half of basketball. Left side, Durant. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
Even though he isn't having the best of games from the floor, it hasn't seemed to hurt him.
And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time. The whistle blowing. And there's the call. Oklahoma City with the foul. The Clippers have looked good at the line. They're perfect in four attempts.
Two shots.
And he makes the first.
A lot of high hopes for the Thunder heading into last season's playoffs, and it didn't go quite as they had planned.
And Oklahoma City making a change here. Collison's out there, and so Jamal Crawford nails both of them. The Thunder would come back from the first round scare nicely as they got rid of the Clippers in the second round.
And it looked like they would be in for a good fight against the Spurs in the conference finals, but this kind of faded away as that series wore on. And I think that was more what San Antonio did than what the Thunder didn't do.
They played their best basketball with Spurs, obviously, late in the season.
They raised it each series. It seemed as though they got to another number.
Hit it at the right time. Mm-hmm. 58 seconds left to play here in the half. Now Fermont. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Shot clock at 6. Kicks it to Crawford. And it comes off the front of the rim.
An easy look there, but, you know, he misses those once in a while.
It's Durant with the drop.
Oh, my goodness. What a huge play.
Hard, high, and strong. Give it up.
Their bench just erupts at that one. They loved it.
Slick. That was just amazing to watch.
32 seconds left to play in the first half. Ball's knocked loose. Over in the corner, Barnes. And again, it's the Clippers missing. The Thunder leading by 11. Here's Durant. Gets to the rim for 2 with the D all over him. Durant's got 12 in the game.
And he may be the guy to put this game even farther out of reach.
It's Crawford with the drive. Crawford with another miss.
Even though he missed it, he couldn't pass up that chance.
Yeah, that's an easy jump shot. You got to take that.
Now they've gotten something out of just about every possession, and their defense has been just as good. Masterful performance across the board.
And don't forget, on the road, too.
And that does it for the first half of play. Thunder out in front as they end the second quarter on a 14-6 run. And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Yes, Kevin, I'm here with Russell Westbrook. And Russell, how confident are you that regardless of what defender you see in front of you, you can get what you want?
Very confident. I have a lot of confidence in myself. I put a lot of work in the summertime. I'm very confident.
Russell, thank you so much. Kevin, hard work pays off.
Thank you so much, Doris. Great interview as always. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back with the second half of basketball shortly. And as we welcome you back, we begin our second half. So far, not a tightly contested game, guys, but, you know, anything can happen. We've seen Kevin Durant really having a great game.
Yeah, what a remarkable half, the way he attacked the rim and scored in the paint. Defenders, you know, they were trying to slow him down any way possible, but he still got through.
Easier said than done when he's the penetrator. His speed and agility make him extremely hard to defend.
Clippers trail by 15.
Thunder head coach Scott Brooks really consistent with his message. It's all about defensive commitment and trusting your teammates at that end of the floor.
Second half is underway, and here's who Scott Brooks has got on the floor. Locking at the four with Perkins at the pivot. Morrow is the two with Durant the three. And it's Westbrook in at the point guard. Outside Durant. He dishes it to Perkins. Puts up the baby hook. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. You talk about Scott Brooks' defensive focus. He played 11 years in the NBA as a 5'11 point guard, Steve. You'd better believe he had some toughness.
Oh, he was nasty. He would pick you up full court. And, you know, he had there was a great stat about him when he played. He went five consecutive seasons where he had more steals than turnovers. So shows you about Scott Brooks.
The first free throw is good.
The Clippers started out as a good team last year, but they never seemed to be content with what they had. They added vet after vet as the season progressed and really made some nice additions.
He's off on the second. And the Clippers' depth was a big help for him in the first round as the bench provided, I thought, Clark, a good punch for him against the Golden State Warriors.
You know, that's true, but they just didn't have enough in the tank to get by the Thunder in that second round of the playoffs and what was really, I thought, an entertaining back-and-forth series.
Clippers trail by 16. Paul with the ball. Westbrook picks him up. Griffin sets the screen for Paul. Jordan, the pass to Paul. Back to Jordan. Shot clock at six. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Paul's got three assists tonight. Paul with the steal. Pass to Griffin. No one near him. Good on the jump shot. Griffin's got his second basket.
Up and in on every one of their first three shots to start the second half.
Pass to Durant. Perkins with a screen on Barnes. He's off from 17 feet.
Really good offensive execution. Nice pick. Good shot to go.
Boy, you love to see that as a basketball purist. Guy setting a good screen and then getting the shot opportunity.
That could give him a huge injection of energy, Clark.
And Kevin, that's exactly what they need right now. They've got to close the gap.
Forget about that for a second. How about the burst to the bucket for a point guard? Boy, he can power those down.
And first timer of the game called for Oklahoma City.
Matt Barnes, really a good glue guy. He rebounds, defends. He's gotten better with his outside shot, and he can really run the lane. And he's always had a toughness and a fearlessness that I think a lot of coaches love.
Outside Westbrook. Here's Ibaka. Perkins dishes to Ibaka. Shoots over Griffin, and there's Ibaka. That's good on the assist by Perkins.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
And the Clippers call time here.
They've been committing a lot of turnovers, and I imagine that's exactly what they're talking about right now. They need to tighten it up.
After the break in the action, we've got a chance now to look at last year's top rebounders. DeAndre Jordan, number one.
I know he took a lot of pride in being at the top of that list when all was said and done. I mean, just a man among boys out there.
Clippers trail by 12. And here is Paul. Crawford outside. Plenty of space. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. And that's 13 points for Crawford. The Thunder have gone 2-4 here to start the second half. Here's Durant. And that one's good. And the Thunder lead by 12.
This seems like they're finding an open lane to the hoop every time down. That's five buckets in a row for them in the paint.
Yeah, on the flip side, Steve, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
And it's out of bounds to the Clippers as the Clippers retain possession. Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. And that one's good, Barnes.
Boy, this is the kind of shooting performance coaches dream of. It makes their job so much easier. An excellent start to this third quarter.
Here's Westbrook. Again, the Thunder score. Clippers with the ball. Down by 12. Moving on from this game, they're scheduled to take on the Lakers at the Staples Center. That will be a getaway game for them, a one-game road trip. And here's Barnes for three, and he gets it to go. Barnes has got 5 points now in the quarter.
I'm not sure that was the play they had set up, but it was too good a look to pass it.
Westbrook drives in from deep. Morrow. Jordan with the rebound. Jordan's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
You know, you could tend to think of the Thunder as a top-heavy team with the all-stars they have, but they actually get a lot of production from their bench, which makes them a championship-caliber team.
Durant gets to Ibaka. Griffin with some nice D.
That's an easy shot there. That's a shot that he should make more often than not.
Barnes passes to Crawford. Another one falls for the Clippers. This Thunder team was very deep last year, as you said. They were third in the league, Steve, in bench minutes play.
And even though the bench wasn't really carrying the offensive load, you know, they were good defensively and they kept things close. Really, all they needed to do was eat minutes, and they did that a lot last year.
Knocks it loose. And the Thunder pushing it up now. Westbrook's got the ball. A second chance effort. No good from Durant.
That's terrific defense right there to prevent from converting in close.
At the floor.
And no question, he got bumped on that shot.
Definitely no room for discussion on that one.
And taking a quick look here at the hustle stats for the Thunder.
How about all the points they're getting off turnovers?
Another part of their game that's made a difference tonight is all the second chance points they've been able to get.
Well, when you talk about vocal leaders among NBA players, you'd have to put Chris Paul right at the top of the list. Always talking, a coach on the floor, but also makes his teammates better.
J.J. Redick's checked in for the Clippers. Steven Adams is checked in for Oklahoma City. Reggie Jackson comes in for Russell Westbrook. And out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession.
It's such a careless pass. You've got to keep your head in the game here.
Spencer Hawes is checked in for Jordan. Clippers trail by 7.
And you know, Chris Paul is what looks to be a natural leader. You take a look at him being elected the president of the NBA's Players Union. I think that indicates the respect he has on both sides of the aisle, with his peers, but also with those in management as well. Highly respected, not only because of his performance, but because of his character as well.
He's a grinder. Love what he does under the offensive boards, really bringing energy and life to his team.
Redick for three, and a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Paul's got his 7th assist in the game. Oklahoma City leading by 3. And Chris Paul not shy about voicing his opinion, Steve, when it comes to Clippers' decisions in the front office.
No, but that's healthy, you know, particularly with his relationship with Doc Rivers. So, you know, Paul was instrumental in acquiring Barnes and Jamal Crawford. You know, look, when you have a star player, you should go to him for advice occasionally.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
Outside Griffin. Misses from close range.
Boy, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Love jumper, and Durant gets it to go. The assist from Ibaka. 16 points for Kevin Durant.
Well, and the bounce pass was the key to the play.
13 feet away. Here's Barnes, and the bucket counts. He's on his way to the free throw line. Trying to make it a three-point play.
You know, if you were only looking at the way he's played offensively, you'd think his team would be ahead.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Glenn Davis has checked in for Griffin. And it's Farmar in for Chris Paul. The Thunder also changing it up. Collison comes in for Serge Ibaka. And Jeremy Lamb subbed in for Anthony Morrow. Dishes it to Durant. Fires the three. And again, Oklahoma City with the triple.
You know, their three-point shooting since halftime is about as good as you could possibly ask for, guys.
Now's the time to put the pedal to the metal, boys. Keep firing those deep balls and build that lead up.
Here's Farmar, guarded by Jackson. Reddick with the three. That's good. Reddick's got 9 points in the quarter.
The rapid-fire threes coming from everywhere.
I thought it might be a little improvement to try to get those points right back, but it worked.
Lamb, and again, Oklahoma City with the triple.
A wide-open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Clippers trail by 8. There's the double team with Lamb. Farmar dishes to Reddick. Now here's Barnes. 10 points for him. 5 to shoot. The feed to Farmer. Takes the three. And again, Los Angeles with the triple. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Jackson kicks to Durant. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer off lock. And here's the fast break. Here's Farmer. And it's Durant with the rebound. Durant's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Here's Jackson. The basket good off the assist from Durant. Jackson's got 5 now.
Boy, nice work inside. Tough to get that shot over a big defender like that.
No, that takes skill and creativity, Steve. Particularly on the release to make sure he doesn't get a hand on it. Boy, I tell you what, he's having one of those days where if he takes it, he makes it.
Can't get it to go. Shots continuing to fall as we conclude the third quarter. Both teams putting up points. Thunder lead by 5. We'll be back shortly live from Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles.
Scary night of basketball. Halloween in the NBA. Tim Duncan and the San Antonio Spurs take on Goran Dragic and the Phoenix Suns. This Friday, 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific.
Brief chance to view our State Farm assist of the game. It's 1 of 7 terrific assists on the night from Chris Paul.
And what you love about his ability to pass the ball, Kevin, is that it just seems so natural to him, so fluid. He's always in control, understanding where his teammates are and anticipating passing angles.
The Thunder leading by 5. Our fourth quarter action underway, presented by Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups. Taking a look at Los Angeles. We've got Crawford. DeAndre Jordan is out there with Davis. And there's Farmer. And it's Reddick in at the 2-guard. LA's gone a terrific 5 of 6 from beyond the arc in this game. There it is, guys. That Olay defense. just watching him go, Clark, right by.
I think we might be seeing which team is ready to take control of this game.
Yeah, that's a dunk that could absolutely get them going. I agree, Clark.
Releases, and Davis pulls it down.
Boy, he should have made that one. He had plenty of cushion between himself and the defender.
And the foul called on Russell Westbrook. That is his first foul of the game. Griffin's checked in for the Clippers. Paul comes in for Jordan Farmer. And a switcher also for Oklahoma City. Ibaka's checked in. The dish to Redick. Back to Paul. And he lobs it up to the rim. Stolen away. Nice job to interrupt the alley-oop attempt there. Jackson kicks to Ibaka. Let's it fly. Almost, but it rolls out. Clippers trail by three. Crawford with the ball. Westbrook picks him up. Crawford passes to Paul. Tipped away. Oh, and here we go. Jackson, nobody back. Finishes the break with a slam.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
Out of bounds, Clippers ball as the Clippers keep possession. Anthony Morrow's checked in for Oklahoma City. Crawford, no one around him. That drops and it comes off an assist from Jordan. 22 points for Crawford.
They're relying on their three-point shooting and getting pretty good results right now.
Yeah. In fact, three of the last five makes is from beyond the arc.
Serge Ibaka, the 24th pick by the Thunder back in 2008. From the start, Steve, his incredible work ethic has shown through.
No doubt, Kevin, he's become one of the best two-way players in the NBA. Excellent defender, can guard fours and fives. A terrific weak side shot blocker. And that jump shot, that 17-footer, that has given Oklahoma City the spacing that that offense needs.
And for Ibaka, his offseason trainer also worked with Kevin Garnett. And he said that's who Ibaka reminds him of, with his intensity and attention to detail and drill. And that's something that's overlooked. Being a perfectionist while you're practicing allows you to perform at a high level. And he's the type that wants to do it again and again until he gets it right.
Griffin sets the screen for Crawford. Can't make good off the screen. The Thunder leading by three. Outside Westbrook, he kicks to Ibaka. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Griffin's got six rebounds here tonight.
And, you know, you think about Ibaka's development. Part of his adjustment to the NBA initially was just learning the language. When he first was drafted, he barely spoke a lick of English, and now it's become his fifth language.
Durant kicks to Westbrook. This one for three, and that one's good. And the Thunder lead by four.
Got a lot of momentum going with his own game. It's been great today, and just as hot as he was last time out.
And the foul called on Russell Westbrook. That's foul number two for him. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Clippers will return possession. And stolen by Perkins. And pushing it up here. Here is Oklahoma City.
So deflating for a team. Clark coughing up the ball at one end, and then it turns into immediate points at the other end.
And it's just as much of a boost for the team getting those easy points off the steal.
Ball outside. Crawford dishes direct. Crawford with the ball. Guarded now by Durant. Crawford's shot is good. And we may have an injury here that does not look good.
No, this is the last thing you ever want to see at a game.
You know, at this point, we can just knock on wood, say a prayer, and wish him the best.
Matt Barnes has checked in for the Clippers.
Although they didn't end with the best record in the West, the Clippers were one of the top teams against the West. and a terrific in-conference record.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. As you guys said, the Clippers did very well in the conference. 36 wins for them, which tied them with the Thunder, Steve, for the second-best mark.
Well, you have to be able to dominate like that if you're going to win your division, and that's what the Clippers were able to do last season for the second straight year.
Go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Hi, guys. I had a chance to find out what Scott Brooks was discussing with his players. He gave his guys the green light to keep firing from downtown, telling them, listen, I like the work you're doing out there. Keep finding those gaps on the perimeter. They're giving us open shots.
Shots good by Ibaka.
Seems like they're on their heels every time defensively because the ball continues to go into the post.
Well, if they don't pick up the aggression, things are only going to get worse.
Yep, it goes, and the Oklahoma City leaders get down to four again on the bucket from Barnes. The Thunder have gone 4 of 8 in this fourth quarter, shooting an even 50% from the field. Westbrook kicks to Morrow. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. Westbrook's got his fourth assist in this one. The Clippers have gone 5 of 6 from the field to start the fourth quarter on a roll. Paul against Westbrook. Paul passes to Redick. A three. It's good, and the Thunder lead is cut back down to 4 with the made basket from Paul.
This is great. Three-pointers going down quickly at both ends.
Yeah, it took them no time to answer back on that possession.
Now the pass to Ibaka. Deflects the pass. A chance here to get a quick injury report. Let's get a Doris Burke update on the injury to Crawford. Doris?
Well, guys, I had a moment to catch up with the head athletic trainer for Los Angeles. It's bad news, I'm afraid. He's saying that it looks like a broken ankle, which can truly be a devastating injury. That's a bitter pill for them to swallow at such an early stage of the season. It really changes the look of this entire team, guys.
Thank you, Doris. Boy, you always hate to see anyone ever deal with any sort of injury.
Yeah, but it's part of the game, Kevin. Almost everybody goes through it eventually as a player, so you just have to deal with it the best you can.
Unfortunately, it is that, Steve, and it's painful to watch your teammates out there because you're helpless in that situation.
Feeds to Durant. Pulls up. And it's good. Fought through contact, hits the shot, and go to the free throw line.
They'll be counting on even more points from him. That's essential if they're going to pull this game out.
Durant doing all sorts of things. He has 23 points, and his huge assist tally makes it all the more impressive.
Well, and he's got this team in such a good groove right now. The way he's moving the ball and passing, getting everybody involved, they're in a great flow.
Clippers trail by 3. And the Clippers call time here. We've seen Kevin Durant really having a great game.
He's getting to the rack all game, and if they can't do a better job of keeping him out of the paint, they're in for a long night.
Redick, not a lot of room. Paul dishes to Griffin. Free throw line jump shot. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Perkins got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one. And the basket by Morrow. Morrow's got 11 in the second half.
The defense pretty much helpless there stopping that layup. I think too much of a mismatch in terms of height.
Got a piece of it and stolen by Perkins. Teardrop shot.
Yeah, he got waxed. Shouldn't be much debate on that one.
Yeah, that was as straightforward as it gets, guys.
Their lead to 6. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 7-point game.
And no mistakes there. A couple of good free throws to give them a little extra cushion.
Jordan with a screen on Westbrook. Back to Paul. They need this. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Jordan. Jordan's got 4 assists now tonight.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
It's just beautiful basketball to watch, Mark.
Here's Westbrook, drilled from 11 feet out. Westbrook's got 5 points now in the quarter.
You know, they've been able to depend on his offense all game long, guys. He's drained a lot of shots out here.
And between now and the horn, Steve, the ball should be in his hands as much as possible if they want to continue to build this lead.
Los Angeles calls timeout. They're behind by 6. 1:22 left in the fourth quarter. Side. They get a hand on it. And pushing it up here. Here is Oklahoma City. Westbrook leading the charge.
Really not hard to see why they're giving up points on this run. I mean, they've just given them too many looks inside.
Yeah, I mean, they're just getting pounded in there. The defense not offering much resistance. They've got to force the ball back out to the perimeter.
Now here's Redick. Tight defense on him. He feeds it to Paul. Kendrick Perkins grabs the miss. Oklahoma City has gone 2 for 2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. Westbrook kicks to Durant. Shot is off. So the Clippers will take it the other way. Here's Redick. Good, and Paul gets the assist.
Gotta love the finger roll up and over the defense.
And now they decide to foul intentionally.
Well, Westbrook has been great. He has 15 points, and he has been the definition of a thief with all those steals.
I'll say, I mean, defensively, he's fought his way through this game beautifully. They haven't gotten away with any loose passes, any sloppy ball handling when he's in the vicinity.
And he cannot get the first one to drop. Tough one to miss. And the Clippers making a switch here. Farmar's checked in. So he comes up empty at the line. Los Angeles has gotten off to a great start from three-point range in the final quarter. They're a perfect 3 of 3. 7-second difference, shot and game clock, and the wing jumper up one. And they go to the intentional foul.
At the line of the thunder, Kendrick Perkins. 2 shots.
First free throw is good, and that makes it a 7-point lead. J.J. Redick's checked in for Jordan Farmar. And a new group in here for the Thunder. Steven Adams, he's checked in for Durant. Collison comes in for Serge Ibaka. Jeremy Lamb's checked in for Anthony Morrow. And Reggie Jackson subbed in for Russell Westbrook. So So he gets them both, and it's an 8-point game. And the Clippers call time here. They trail by 8. 20 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Here for the Clippers. Spencer Hawes is checked in for Jordan. Davis comes in for Blake Griffin. Hedo Turkoglu's checked in for Matt Barnes. And it's Farmar in for Paul. And a switch here also for Oklahoma City. Jones checked in for Kendrick Perkins. Here's Hawes. Busts the J after the cagey pass fake. And he commits the intentional foul. So the first one drops, and that makes it a 7-point lead. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's an 8-point game. We've got 13 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Redick with it. Let's it go with the three. No good. So it's Oklahoma City picking up the win. It was a solid win, Clark.
Yeah, it was, and I think it came down to will more than skill. They went out and got this one.
And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Yes, thank you, Kevin. Russell, obviously your ability to attack on offense is such a key for your team. How do you decide when to go to the hoop and when to pass the ball?
I never know, man. I just see how the flow of the game is going. I try to stay in attack mode. That's what my team wants me to do, and I try to continue to do it.
Russell, thank you. Kevin, he does it brilliantly.
Thank you, Doris, for that. And now for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan saying see you next time as we present our Jordan Player of the Game, Kevin Durant.
Okay, so great game there for the Thunder. A good, healthy win, 100-92. And we'll see here the numbers there. You see Jamal Crawford, 24 points in the ball game from him. J.J. Redick was on fire there for a while there. Had a tough time going against him. He has 19. Paul there, you see, he gets his double-double, 11 points, 11 rebounds. And there you see also some other players there scoring there. There, Blake Griffin, we actually got to be able to shut him down. He had 4 points, 7 rebounds. So that was good stopping him down there in the low post. But yeah, overall, it was a really great game. Did a great job there. Unlike the first game where we almost let that one go. But you see, Kevin Durant, 26 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists. Morrow, 18 points, 2 rebounds, 1 assist. Westbrook, 15 points, 2 rebounds, and 5 assists there for him. 6 steals also in the game. He almost had a triple-double. Perkins, 14 points, 9 boards there, and 3 assists there for him. And then you guys can go ahead and just check out the rest there. But overall, really great game there. Really impressed with the way Perkins playing the ball game. But there you see the team comparison there. You guys can pause the video and check that out of what the teams did there. What I liked the most there would probably be the steals. And, of course, the defensive rebounding there for the Clippers was really good. 27 boards right there. We need to work on defensive boards there. I had a little trouble there throughout the game. But, like I said, it's just game the first, you know, just the first game or second game of the season. There you see bench points, 31 points for the Clippers. did a better job of getting scoring points from the bench there than we did. We only got 18. But there you see the points in the paint right there, 52 to 44. There, the difference between the Thunder getting 52 and 48 for the Clippers. So we get an off day here on Halloween, so we get to celebrate Halloween, go back home and celebrate with our family and whatnot. And then we get to come back home on the first here. As you see, we get ready for the Nuggets. So there you see, final score 100 to 92. Like I said, a great game right there. Really show the Clippers that we were not going to take it from them, and that we were going to go ahead and take that ball game and do something with it. So I think here we're about to see what our social media there, is. As you see, we got about 19 messages there, and hopefully we'll get to that here very soon. But like I said, great game right there, and I was really impressed that we were able to stop Blake Griffin. I know in games past, last year's game, I had a tough time with the Clippers, especially with Blake Griffin, and I believe Jordan. Oh my goodness, just couldn't do anything with them down there in the paint and stuff. So, but we'll go ahead here and we'll sim, like I said, Halloween. We got a rest day, and then go ahead. Like I said, we got our next game, and our first game, our home opener here, against the Nuggets. There you see 80 overall, and they have not played a game since their first game. They're still 1-0 for the season. As you see there, we jump up to now first place here against them. So, like I said, we'll have a great game against them. Always a good game against them. They're usually one of my if not the toughest team I have here playing, especially against the West besides the Spurs. But we'll see how they are this year's game. I really don't know who the players are this year, because I know there have been a lot of changes there. But we'll see here through social media there. You should see some messages there with some other teams, and also some insiders there talking about the games that have already been played. And players talking about what they've done on the court, or what they're going to do to other people on the court. I know there's a lot of trash talking as of late. You see Paul Pierce talking about the Knicks and how bad they beat them in their game. So we'll have to definitely check out more of the social media here in the next couple of episodes. But like I said, you guys, I hope you guys are enjoying the games in its entirety. I think it's the best way is to show you guys what I'm doing and how awful or how good I am in this game. Not really that great in NBA games, but I do have a lot of fun with them. So I hope you guys enjoy this series and whatnot. So definitely come on back for another episode of My GM here on NBA 2K15 with the Oklahoma City Thunder. If you guys enjoy the video, please leave a like. Also, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe and check out other great series here on ESGN.net. Also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Tumblr. All those links are down below in the description, and definitely check us out and spread the word about ESGN.net. As always, I'll see you guys next time.